And economists are tipping the unemployment rate could rise much higher than expected and hit 7% by the end of the year. There was a huge fall in the number of job advertisements last month, and analysts are warning that demand for employment.
While unemployment was always going to be a talking point, the statement.
And here I was, very highly qualified, with a lot of experience, not very old. Back then I was only in my 30s, you know, early 30s and stuff, and not even able to get a single interview, which was very strange. My wife at the time was thinking maybe you're doing something wrong, and we just went through the whole process, re-examined how we wrote our CV, maybe take a few things out, add a few things in, always tell the truth. But, you know, look at stuff, but never. And so I applied, my assessment, I lost count after a while, but I think I applied for about 200 jobs.
I was very upset at the time, I couldn't find a job. But at least I have a part-time job, I have a casual job to work as a cashier in Woolworths. So I still get some income, lot of them. I send my resume every week, I think more than maybe more than 300 resumes I have sent.
300?
Yeah. And I have attended several interviews, but not successful.
I remember those days when I was actually looking into my pocket and saying if I would spend $1 for a drink. So every morning I was going outside, I was going out with my food, you know, so I didn't have to buy food outside because I wanted to save my money.
I applied for a couple of jobs in the sector, but I couldn't get even an interview. I'm not sure what's the reason, maybe because of my qualification or the experience not in that sector. That could be one reason, or maybe, I don't know, maybe there's some other reason. It said that my skill is very good, but my English is not good enough, so that's why I was failed.
There are a number of challenges or difficulties that they face. Probably the most significant one is the language barrier, I hate to say, but also their accent. Sometimes I found that with some of my clients, if a person had a very strong accent and it was a little bit difficult to understand.
The new, you know, the immigrants, they have a high expectation. They feel that they have come to a country of opportunity, so all the jobs are waiting for them, and they'll have to get it like that. But that's not the case, and we cannot expect it. That's a wrong way of approaching to any job. You'll have to start from somewhere.
From my experience, what I have found is in Australia, rather than your academic qualification, your work experience is really it's important. It's important, and I think they look for your experience and your skill, what skill you've got, and how much and how you can contribute, you know, to their requirement, or how well do your skill match their requirement.
The first is having unrealistic expectations about their ability to gain employment in terms of the time frame. So I met a lot of migrants who you know, had been here for a couple of weeks or even a month or 2 months, and were really expected to find employment quite quickly.
So it was very difficult when you're just constantly putting in so much effort into applying for jobs and not even getting a call to say, can you come in to talk to us? And I suspected there was an element of racism and exclusivity going on. There has to be this the perception of that certain jobs are suitable only for certain people from certain cultural backgrounds.
Yeah,
but at least I get an interview experience, so I know how to do best next time. I know what they usually to ask.
Okay.
And then what's the process of the interview.
And there's a limit to what you can do. Job applications, for a lot of the jobs that I apply for are professional type jobs. And it takes a long time to write a job application. You just don't do have a job application and put it for every job, because you got to look at the job specs, what they want, and then you got to write to address the criteria they want you to address, to want you to answer to.
So if they've only been here for a short period of time, obviously their expression and their ability to go through their CV or resume quite fluently and confidently is impacted greatly.
I took a photograph. I put the photograph, me big head smiling, and put some Photoshop and made myself handsome. Put it on the CV next to my name, right? Printed it out and then sent it in. Sent it in by email. I got a call within 2 hours.
I negotiated with one of the migrant resource center to do a placement, free volunteer placement. I started doing that. And that was a big help because I could actually put their details into my resume saying that I'm doing some work. And just to carry one, small card, writing all my skills there and my contact number at the back. And I used to give it to everyone saying that if you know any opportunity, give me a call. I'll be happy to face the interview.
Also, just some cultural barriers as well, like the way that we behave in interviews, I think, is impacted by our culture and just, some people had difficulty making eye contact, some people had difficulty shaking hands very firmly or confidently, or even shaking hands at all. And I found some people were a little bit passive or very quiet or shy in interviews, and I noticed that of people from certain cultures as well.
Actually, I attended a program named SNMP, which is Skill Migrant Mentoring Program in Sydney Community School. Sydney Community College. So I get an opportunity to work as a work experience for 2 weeks here. Just work, without pay. Yeah, for 2 weeks. And then I'm so lucky, it just has a vacancy, so I applied for it.
At the moment, I'm lucky. Last year, I got a full-time position at this university, but only for 1 year.
Okay, when I arrived here, I came to know about the course St. John's is conducting on work placement and work culture. And I enrolled in the course, and through that course, I was able to do work experience in St. John's Migrant Resource Center for a couple of weeks. And then at that time, the center, they have announced a vacancy, and I applied for that, and I got the job. And also, that work experience helped me a lot in terms of gaining confidence. And luckily, I'm working in Migrant Resource Center, who work for migrant. So the sector has that kind of, understanding. And they understand the problem of migrant.
That was a major challenge a lot of people faced. I know I need to get local experience, but I don't have local experience. How do I start? How do I get an employer to, give me that chance to get my foot in the door and start that?
Well, honestly speaking, I didn't have much experience working with employment services. The reason is that the kind of work that I was looking at, I think the employment service was not capable of offering me the much opportunity. So at the moment, within a week, I could understand that. So when I understood that, I said that I'm actually looking for jobs in community sector, full-time or part-time community sector, as a youth worker or community welfare worker. And I found that the employment services were very much they were very good at offering the casual jobs, different kinds of other jobs which didn't actually fit me. So what I did is, instead of depending on them, I started finding my own way.
I can attend a program named SkillMax. This program helped us to know more about Australia and teach us how to prepare for interview and how to write a cover letter and resume. Yeah, I registered in, what's that, Centrelink, and then they advised me to attend the job network where I can use the computer and photocopier and printer for free. Mm-hmm. They didn't help me to find a job actually. I think maybe different job networks is different. My ones not help me to find a job, to get a job.
In fact, they've been an impediment. I felt the government has been an impediment for me. A lot of the Centrelink services have been useless in respect to my experience. I can't speak for others, but in my experience, Centrelink services and other, I don't know, this job network thing, you know, has been absolutely useless. Most of them do not deal with professional jobs. I went to them asking for assistance, and they said, go to this place. I can't remember who it was, one of the job network people. And they looked at my qualifications and said, we can't help you. They said, why? We don't handle these sort of jobs. You've got to look for it yourself.
The network. So once I actually understood that, I started talking to different people and trying to find the opportunity.
Connections. Networking. You need networks. I got this job largely because a friend recommended me to apply for this job. And I've also worked in this research center which I'm at the moment, previously as a casual. So I've been there a few months before. So they knew me, they knew my face. And so when I applied for the job, I was quite familiar. And also they based it on my CV and my publications and stuff. So that helped quite a bit. But it's connections, you know. I'm not saying that they only, because they knew me, they gave me the job. They didn't do that only, but it helped to a significant degree. So it's very difficult for me to advise people coming here that are new, because people come here that are new, have no connections, they have no networks. So you ask me, what are my opinions on that? My opinions are going to be very pessimistic, very negative.
Make more friends, which will help you. Mm. Actually, my first job is introduced by my friend. Mm. And my second job, which is a community language teacher, is introduced by my friend as well. So friend will help you. Just don't stay at home by yourself. Go out and talk to others and make friends. It will be very helpful.
So I think it is your responsibility to prove, to market your skill. Let us know, let other people know that you are good at this and that, and they will take you. But if we expect that, we are the newcomer here, so people should give us the opportunity, I think that's not right. Because there is a competition. You'll have to compete with the mainstream.
Definitely I have that feeling, because I came from a different culture, different background, different working situations. So definitely it's not, there's a competition. And the migrant or the new arrivals has to put in some extra effort to beat that competition. So I think the most important thing is to learn work culture.
To practice English as much as you can.
Firstly, the wider issue of racism in Australia has to be addressed.
I truly believe that one job is waiting for you somewhere. You go and find